today our class is simple complex compound, which is a typical topic. At the same time, it is very useful and important topic too. I suggest you all try to follow 3 episodes of this class without fail to understand the better. If you just watch first episode and leave, you do not understand. Watch all the 3 episodes without fail, certainly you will learn in a better way and you will score even better in your examinations. What are these simple, complex and compound sentences? Simple, complex, compound sentences are the sentences which are used to make our language convenient and free to speak. Either you write a sentence in simple or in complex or in compound, we don't find any difference in the meaning among these 3 sentences. But the only reason of using these 3 sentences in the language to make our language beautiful, to make our language simple, to make our language convenient means we can express one idea in 3 different ways. That is the reason these sentences are named simple, complex, compound. Now let me go to the simple sentence and explain you how do you differentiate a simple sentence and a grammatical simple sentence. A simple sentence is made up of 2 parts. They are subject part, at the same time a predicate part. Let us see on the board what is a simple sentence. A simple sentence is made up of 1 subject and 1 predicate. 1 subject and 1 predicate is a simple sentence. Let us see the example here. He worked hard. He is the subject. Worked hard is a predicate. Is a predicate. O plus any other word. Generally we call it as a predicate. Rest of the part of the sentence is called as a predicate. A simple sentence is made up of what? A subject and predicate. Remember this. But there is a difference between a simple sentence and a grammatical simple sentence. What is the difference between a simple sentence and a grammatical simple sentence? A simple sentence is just like a class and gives complete meaning by itself, and it consists of only 1 subject and 1 predicate. Coming to the grammatical simple sentence, grammatical simple sentence has additional addition of a phrase to the class. Means a grammatical simple sentence consists of 1 phrase and 1 clause. Means clause is nothing but a subject and predicate together, which can give complete meaning itself, which we will discuss when we come to complex and compound sentences. So, my dear students, we find a grammatical simple sentence with a phrase and a clause. Let us see the sentence. Working hard is a phrase, but whereas in the first sentence he worked hard. Worked hard is a predicate part, verb plus adverb. Together we just found in a simple sentence. But coming to the grammatical simple sentence, in grammatical simple sentence we found only a phrase. A phrase. Then when I use the word phrase, there might be a doubt what is a phrase and how to make a class into phrase. Let us now understand what is a phrase and how to make a class into phrase. The most important area where a child has to concentrate a lot while converting a class into phrase. My dear students, I am going to show you the simplest techniques how to make a class into phrase. Once if you are confident of learning a class into phrase, it is easy to write any number of sentences in simple complex compound sentences. Right, my dear students, let us understand what is a phrase, what is a class. Once after you understand a class and phrase, I will show you the way how to make a class into phrase. What is a phrase? As we discussed, phrase does not have a verb and a subject. Remember this. A phrase does not have a subject as well as the verb. Whereas a class has a subject, verb, object, means a subject and predicate. It has a subject and predicate and gives complete meaning by itself. When you see these sentences, being poor, is it a class or a phrase? When we see the sentence, being poor, this part does not have any subject and there is no verb even. When we do not find a subject and a verb, my dear students, you can confirm the given part is a phrase. Let us see the second sentence, second part even. Working hard. Is there anybody working here? No. Any subject is seen in the sentence? There is no subject. Where there is no subject and no verb, you can confirm it is a phrase. In phrases, there are different kinds of phrases. It is not required for you to learn about different kinds of phrases, but you have to understand what is difference between a class and phrase. Reason is, in simple complex compound sentences, phrases are very much important in simple sentences. In all the simple sentences, you need to use a phrase and a class. Unless you know what is a phrase and what is a class, you cannot convert the sentences or you cannot write the sentences from simple to complex or complex to simple. It's a very, very important area to be noted, my dear students. Now, once if you are clear about the phrase, then let us understand what is a class. A class is nothing but which has a subject and predicate in a sentence, which has a subject and predicate and also gives complete meaning by itself, is called a class. In the other words, if you ask me to say what is class, I can simply say that a class is nothing but an independent sentence. A class is nothing but an independent sentence. Now in the class, what do we have? We find the subject. There is a subject here. Have a problem is a predicate. Have is a verb and a problem noun. We can see a subject. At the same time, we find a predicate. A subject and predicate together gives complete meaning by itself without depending on anything else. This is what we call a class. Classes are of two types. What are those two classes? Generally, we discuss in school level main class and subordinate class. What is a main class? What is a subordinate class? A main class is nothing but a sentence, whereas A subordinating class is also a sort of sentence, but it cannot give complete meaning by itself. Why? When the subordinating conjunctions are used along with the class, automatically the main class becomes a subordinate class. How? They have problem. This is a sentence which gives complete meaning by itself. Instead, they have a problem. If I write though they have a problem, though they have a problem, so what? Now, even in the subordinating class, we find the subject part, we find the predicate part. We find the subject as well as predicate. Then what is the difference? Well, the only difference between these two sentences is the subordinating conjunction. The subordinating conjunction made the entire main class as the subordinating class. Hence, it cannot give complete meaning by itself, though it has a subject and predicate. Let us see the second sentence. We completed the work. As we completed the work, as we completed the work, as we completed the work. What is the difference between we completed the work and as we completed the work? Only as is added here. As is added, as is written before the sentence, the entire sentence lost its independency. Now it has become a dependent sentence. So here the subordinating conjunction is used along with the class. When a subordinating conjunction is used along with the class, the main class has become the subordinating class. Henceforth, a student has to clearly understand what is a class, what is main class, what is subordinating class. These are going to play a very, very important role in simple complex compound. What is a phrase? What is a class? What is a subordinating class? Remember this. A phrase is nothing but a few words without the subject and verb. Classes are of two types. They are main class and subordinating class. Main class has subject and verb and gives complete meaning by itself. Subordinating class also has a subject and predicate, but it cannot give a complete meaning by itself because the class is supported by the subordinating conjunctions. Let us see subordinating conjunctions when I explain complex sentences. Now we move on to how to change a clause into phrase. How many ways are there to make a clause into phrase? My dear students, if this part is understood, the rest of the topic will be easy for you all. Try to pay utmost attention while listening to conversion of clause into phrase. How to make a clause into phrase? There are two ways to make a clause into phrase. The first way of making a clause into phrase, you see the class. When you see the class, you write the fourth form of the class, means he is a teacher. He is a teacher is a class. When I see the sentence, I can easily make out this has a subject and predicate and gives complete meaning by itself. Henceforth, it is a class. But how can I make a class into phrase? As for the first way of changing a clause into phrase, you see what is the verb of given sentence here. What is the verb of given sentence here? Is. When the verb of given sentence is, you write the fourth form of the verb of the given sentence. So you may ask, sir, what is the fourth form of is? It was already explained when I explained active voice and passive voice. What are the forms of is, are, am? So now the fourth form of is being. Being. Whatever the sentence they give you, whatever the sentence they give you, my dear students, you understand that you try to write the fourth form of the verb given in a sentence. If you write the fourth form of the verb given in a sentence, automatically the entire class becomes phrase. So then what is the phrase of this class? Being a teacher is my being a teacher is my phrase, is my phrase. The other way of writing a class into phrase, let us see one more sentence. After that I'll show you some sentences. He worked hard. He worked hard. What is this? Is it a class or is it a phrase? How do you differentiate? It has a subject and predicate. When it has a subject and predicate, we can easily understand this is a class. When the class is given, you can write the class into phrase by writing the fourth form of the verb given. My dear students, this is the easiest way. You try to maximum follow this technique so that you may not make mistakes in your simple complex compound sentences while you are converting a compound sentence into simple sentence and complex sentence into a simple sentence. What is the fourth form of work? V4 is nothing but V1 plus ing form. So what is the first form of worked? Work. So work, working. Working hard, working hard. This is a phrase. Whatever the sentence they give you, make sure that you write the fourth form of the verb given here. Automatically the entire class becomes a phrase. This is the first and foremost technique that you need to remember. At times it may not be possible. In such cases, my dear students, the second way of writing a class into phrase is, it's very simple and very easy even. You see the subject. What is the subject given here? He is the subject. He is the subject. What is the possessive case of he? The possessive case of he is his. His. What did I ask you? Write the possessive case of the subject. What is the subject here? He is the subject. What is the possessive case of he? His. Then you write his. 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 Then what did I ask you? Once after you write the possessive case, here we find work as a verb, hard as an adverb. Work in the place of verb, hard is in the place of adverb. When you choose a second option or a second choice of converting a sentence from a class into phrase, my dear students, you need to be little bit careful. How? You have to understand and you have to know what is the possessive form of or possessive case of given subject. Once after writing the possessive case of given subject, now you see the sentence worked hard. Worked is a verb. Hard is an adverb. Now what are we supposed to write? Hard has to be brought to the adjective place and work must go to the noun place. This is what I asked you to write, which means his hard work. His hard work. Now here the parts of speech of all these two words. Now hard has become an adjective, work has become a noun. These are the two ways how to change a class into phrase. Let us see 2-3 sentences so that you can understand how to change a class into phrase in a better way. Let us make phrases of these three sentences in the ways what I have shown you. Let us read the first sentence. She is beautiful. What is the first technique that we need to adopt to make a clause into phrase? The first technique is, whatever the verb given in the sentence, you write the fourth form of the verb given in the sentence. Now, what is the fourth form of is? The fourth form of is being. B-E-I-N-G. Being is the fourth form of is or am or was, were. Never forget. The fourth form of be forms is being. So, if I wanted to make this entire clause into a phrase, I should write the fourth form, that is being beautiful. Being beautiful is my phrase. Okay, this is the first technique what I explained, or the first way. What is the second way that we discussed? The second way of writing or converting a clause into phrase is, you need to write the possessive case of the given subject. What is the possessive case of she? The possessive case of she is her. Her. Once after writing the possessive case, then you have to see the adjective. Here the beautiful is adjective. Once, if you write the noun form of the adjective, automatically the clause becomes a phrase. My dear students, her beauty. Her beauty. Now this is also a phrase. What did I do in second part? I just made the subject of given sentence into its possessive case. And then if adjective is given, we have to write as a noun. If adverb and verb is given, adverb automatically becomes an adjective, verb becomes a noun. You just try to remember. If I wanted to suggest you personally, as for my opinion, I ask you people to adopt the first method so that it is easy for you all to rewrite the sentences. Let us see next sentence. He is poor. What is the fourth form of is? The fourth form of is being. So, being poor. Being poor. Now, being poor is a phrase. My dear students, remember clearly and carefully, this part will be shown when I start converting my sentences from simple to complex, complex to compound. This is my first approach. What is my second approach? My second approach is, I have to write the possessive case of the given subject. What is the subject here? He is the subject. What is the possessive case of subject? He, his. Now, let me go with his. His. Poor. Poor is an adjective. Poor is an adjective. But I have to write the noun form of the adjective. What is the noun form of poor? Poverty. His poverty is the phrase here. So, there are two ways how to write a clause into phrase, a phrase into clause. So, we can write being beautiful, being poor, his poverty, her beauty. Let us see the next sentence. He spoke softly. What is the verb given here? It is an action word. Spoke is an action word, not state of being. Spoke is an action word, not state of being. When action word is given, even you need to follow the same technique. The same technique. What is the first approach and first technique that we discussed? The first approach and first technique that what we discussed is writing the fourth form of the given verb. What is the fourth form? V1 plus ing form is nothing but the fourth form. Then what is the first form of spoke? Speak. Then you write ing form, means speaking. Speaking softly. Speaking softly is the first approach. Is the first approach how to make a clause into phrase. Now how can we make a clause into phrase in the second approach? Simple. You write the possessive case of the subject given. What is the subject given in the sentence? He is the subject given. What is the possessive case of he? His. His. Then softly. Softly is an adverb. Softly is an adverb. Then you have to write the adverb as an adjective. So he is soft speech. He is soft speech. Spoke is given here as a action word. So you have to write the noun form of spoke is nothing but speech. So the second way of writing a clause into phrase is his soft speech. His soft speech. This is the way how to make a clause into phrase. Now let us understand and know what is complex sentence, what is compound sentence. My dear students, with this I have given clarity about a simple sentence. A simple sentence is nothing but the combination of a phrase and clause. We got clarity about making a clause into phrase.